Hello and welcome. In this video lesson, we are going to discuss some fundamentals and basics from the topic chemical thermodynamics and energetics. Let us begin with the definition of an energy. Energy of a body is defined as its capacity to perform work, or energy of a body is its stored ability to perform work. Different kinds of energy: gravitational potential energy, energy possessed by a body on account of its position or configuration is known as potential energy. Kinetic energy, energy possessed by a body due to its motion. Heat energy, due to movement of heat energy from the regions of high energy to the areas of low energy. Radiant energy, due to light. Chemical potential energy, due to presence of various bonds in the molecule. Elastic energy, stressed object that returns to its original shape. Electrical energy, it is due to movement of electrons. Nuclear energy, due to atomic fission or fusion. Einstein's mass energy equation. To find mass equivalent of energy, we use Einstein's famous equation, which is E equal to mc square, where E is the energy expressed in joules, m is the mass expressed in kilograms, and c is the speed of light in vacuum, which is equal to 3 into 10 raised to 8 meter per second. Law of conservation of energy. Energy can neither be created nor be destroyed, but it can be converted from one form into another. Total amount of energy of universe always remains constant. Now, what is the meaning of energy transformation? We can convert chemical energy to mechanical energy, or radiant energy to chemical energy, chemical energy to mechanical energy, electrical to thermal, chemical to electrical, etc. Definition of thermodynamics. The branch of science that deals with study of quantitative relationship between heat and other forms of energy is called thermodynamics. The word thermodynamics splits into two words: thermos, meaning warmth or moderate heat, and dynamic, meaning flow. Chemical thermodynamics, a branch of thermodynamics dealing with energy changes accompanying a chemical transformation, is called chemical thermodynamics. According to enthalpy change, we can classify reactions into two types: exothermic reaction and endothermic reaction. Exothermic reaction is one in which energy is given out, and endothermic reaction is one in which energy is absorbed. So this energy change or enthalpy change accompanying a chemical transformation is known as chemical thermodynamics. Energetics. Thermodynamics deals with all types of energies. Hence, nowadays the term energetics is used in place of thermodynamics. Let us discuss limitations of thermodynamics. Thermodynamics considers larger observable quantities such as pressure, temperature, volume, and neglects smaller quantities. Hence, thermodynamics is macroscopic. Absolute values or total values have no meaning in thermodynamics. However, differences or changes are considered. Thermodynamics deals with initial and final state of the system and does not tell anything about the mechanism of the reaction. Thermodynamics does not concern with the theories of matter and anything about individual atom or molecule. Thermodynamics does not tell anything about the rate of chemical reaction. Terms used in thermodynamics. System, a part of universe whose behavior is under thermodynamic consideration is known as system. Boundary, the real or imaginary surface that separates system from surrounding is known as boundary. Through the boundary, energy can be transferred from system to surrounding or from surrounding to system. Surrounding, region outside the boundaries of the system is termed as surrounding. Universe, system and surrounding, together they form universe. Types of system. Open system, the system that exchanges both matter and energy with the surroundings is called open system. Example, reaction carried out in an open container. Closed system, the system that exchanges energy but not matter with the surroundings is called closed system. Example, reaction carried out in closed container. Isolated system, the system that exchanges neither energy nor matter with the surrounding is called isolated system. Example, reaction carried out in thermos flask. Homogeneous system, a system in which both reactants and products have same physical state and are completely miscible is known as homogeneous system. It is completely uniform throughout. All gaseous reactions are homogeneous in nature. Example, hydrogen gas, it combines with chlorine gas to form hydrogen chloride gas. Heterogeneous system, a system in which reactants and products have different physical states and are not completely miscible is known as heterogeneous system. It is not uniform throughout and has two or more phases. Example, solid zinc reacts with aqueous H2SO4 giving aqueous ZnSO4 along with liberation of hydrogen gas. Let us discuss thermodynamic properties of the system. There are two important properties of the system, intensive property and extensive property. A property of system whose value is independent of the quantity of matter present in the system is called intensive property. Example, boiling point. Consider water. Water boils at 100 degrees Celsius or 373 Kelvin. If we take 100 ml of water or 1 liter of water, boiling point is the same. As the boiling point does not depend upon the quantity of matter present, it is an example of intensive property. Other examples of intensive properties are melting point, density, solubility, specific heat capacity, surface tension, temperature, pressure, refractive index, reactivity, radioactivity, half-life period, molar heat capacity, malleability, ductility, thermal conductivity. Extensive property, a property of system whose value depends upon the quantity of matter present in the system is called extensive property. Example, mass. Consider a liter of water, 2 liters of water. We know that the density of water at 4 degrees Celsius is always taken as 1 gram per ml. Therefore, 1 liter of water is equal to 1 kilograms of water, or half liter of water is equal to half kilograms of the water. If we change the quantity, then the mass of the water changes. As the mass depends upon the quantity of matter present in the system, it is an example of extensive property. Other examples of extensive properties are volume, weight, energy, internal energy, work, area, length, entropy, Helmholtz free energy, heat capacity, and enthalpy. State of the system. A system can be defined completely by stating some macroscopic properties such as pressure, volume, temperature, number of moles, and chemical composition. A known set of such observable properties is called state of the system. When one or more properties are changed, then the state of system also changes. Suppose P1, V1, T1, and N1 are the initial pressure, volume, temperature, and moles. If we change pressure to P2, volume to V2, temperature to T2, and number of moles to N2, then the state of the system also changes. Thermodynamic state function and thermodynamic path function. State function. A function whose value depends upon the current state of the system and independent of the path in which the change is carried out is known as state function. Examples of state functions are internal energy, enthalpy, entropy, free energy, pressure, temperature, volume, heat capacity. Thermodynamic path function, a function whose value does not depend upon the current state of the system and depends upon the path in which the change is carried out is known as path function. Examples of path functions are work and heat. Work of pressure volume type. The work done which is due to expansion or compression of a gas against constant opposing pressure is known as pressure volume work or mechanical work. Meaning of delta P and delta V. Suppose P1 is the initial pressure and P2 is the final pressure of the gaseous system, then change in pressure delta P equals P2 minus P1. Similarly, if V1 is the initial volume and V2 is the final volume of the gaseous system, then change in volume delta V equals V2 minus V1. Let us discuss one question. To show delta P change in pressure, delta V change in volume are state functions. Consider system at initial state A with initial pressure P1 and V1. Let the system be changed to state B with final pressure P2 and V2 by any of the paths 1, 2 or 3. In this case, change in pressure delta P equals P2 minus P1 and change in volume delta V equals V2 minus V1 are independent of the path during the process, and hence delta P and delta V are state functions. Thermodynamic equilibrium. A system in which fundamental observable macroscopic properties such as temperature, pressure, volume do not undergo any change with time, then the system is said to be in a state of thermodynamic equilibrium. Examples of thermodynamic equilibrium: thermal equilibrium, mechanical equilibrium, and chemical equilibrium. As discussed, thermodynamic equilibrium involves three kinds of equilibria. Thermal equilibrium, a system in which temperature does not change with time, then the system is said to be in the state of thermal equilibrium. Mechanical equilibrium, a system in which pressure does not undergo any change or no mechanical work is done, then the system is said to be in the state of mechanical equilibrium. Chemical equilibrium, a system in which concentration or chemical composition does not undergo any change with time, then the system is said to be in the state of chemical equilibrium.